Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright,
Ace Attorney,
Trials and Tribulations. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, shit went to hell in a handbasket. Faster than you could say, Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, Trials and Tribulations, which is actually kind of long, I suppose. But anyway, shit went south. We went up into the mountains to some sort of like where Maya lives, but more snow, I suppose. And we came across, not only was it the old crime scene for Dahlia Hawthorne's assumed first murder, but also a murder that happened with this game. It's probably like 10 years ago at this point, but yes, it seems like everything that's been happening at the start of this game's all coming together. So we're going to do the first bit of investigation and see if we can figure out what actually went happen. What happened this fateful night. So, date, who knows? Time, who knows? Location, who knows?
Who could that be at this time of night?
Edgeworth! Yes, Edgeworth speaking.
Edgy, get up! It's an emergency, man!
I don't think it is, you know. I don't know, Larry. You don't sound quite like you're in an emergency.
Larry, do you know what time it is? It's not Larry, it's Loris. Loris Diark's name.
This is nothing more than a terrible nightmare. I'll just roll over and...
But wait, don't hang up. It's an emergency. It's Nick. He took a really nasty spill.
Well, it won't be the first time, so...
I'm not joking. His life is in danger, dude.
What? What happened? Tell me. Tell me! Get out of here, Yugimoto.
Talk about a guy with bad luck. He'd already be dead. Anyway, you gotta come back. You're the only one that can help. My Iris. My beautiful Iris. She needs help.
Alright, I don't know what's going on, but I'll be there as soon as I can.
I'm at the detention center. Please, hurry!
The detention center? Really?
Phoenix Wright has been arrested for falling into a river.
It's been 1 year since I left that country. Thought I wouldn't have to see him again for a while. Sounds like it won't be a pretty reunion. So if I expect again anything to change. Alright, is he flying? Wait, so did he fly out of what I assume is the States or Japan? I think, if it's still saying that this is Japan. Because I know the part of this game, well, part of the translated this game, I don't know if that means they translated it to be in the United States or it's just in Japan but are in English. Who knows?
February 8th, 2:19 PM, Detention Center Visitor's Room.
You're late, Edgy! What took you so long?
I don't want to hear it. I chartered a private jet to come as quickly as I could.
Well, you should have chartered a faster one. Anyway, just listen. Something happened to Miss Elise. And Nick is... Maya and Iris Bikini... Say something, Edgy!
Before I came here, I stopped in at the hospital where Wright is. I believe I have a better understanding of the situation than you at this point. The murder victim was the picture book author, Miss Elise Dioxin. She was found by Wright and the head nun. The suspect is the temple's younger nun. Then later, while Wright was crossing the bridge, it broke and he fell into the river. The hospital says that he'll need at least 2 days of bed rest.
Yeah, that's right, you got it. But they arrested her, my sweet little Iris.
And here I was convinced he was the one the police had arrested. However, I still don't understand what these two items are for.
What are you talking about?
They're things Wright gave to me when I was leaving his room. This is the first. He said some nonsense about being able to see into people's hearts with this. Oh, I've actually got Edgeworth's pictures at all. So we've taken control of Mia. Now we've taken control of Phoenix and now we're controlling Edgeworth. That's amazing. Oh, please tell me we're going to get Edge off investigating with Maya. That'd be brilliant. Oh, Pearls. Who are you, little girl?
I'm Pearls.
I'm the other. He can't possibly ask him what I think he is. Could he? I'm begging you. Iris' trial starts tomorrow. With Nick out of the picture, you've all I got left. You're the one that can represent her.
Wait, why would we be defending someone that we think's done it? Is this pulling the previous game on us again?
What did you just say? You know, represent, defend. What were you expecting? Why do you think I called you anyway, dude?
I'm a prosecutor, Larry. A prosecutor. Do you understand what I'm saying? A prosecutor is a lawyer who...
Don't talk to me like a kid, man. I graduated from junior high, you know. Tell me about it. I promise I won't tell.
But hi. Well, your father was a defense lawyer. It's in your blood.
I mean, I heard a paper badge. I had no problem fooling an entire court before.
How could this country's judicial system have fallen into such decay? Don't ask. For God's sake, don't ask.
Please, Edgy. Please listen to her. Listen to Iris' side of the story.
So Wright wasn't joking when he gave me this badge after all. Yeah, he went kind of Australian there, I apologize.
Thank you for coming. My name is Iris.
Edgeworth. Miles Edgeworth. Does he really not remember? I don't know if I can be of any help, but... I'll at least hear what you have to say about the murder.
Mr. Wright, how is he? Mr. Lurie said that he might even die.
Fortunately, he will be fine. Larry, you moron. How would you say something like that? He was badly bruised when he hit the water, but otherwise he is unharmed.
Thank goodness.
But he's caught some kind of nasty cold.
A cold?
He's running a high fever and is drifting in and out of consciousness. I must be imagining things. This woman, I feel like I've met her before. Okay. Well, but she did actually have a big secret, but obviously Phoenix went into the water before we got a chance to break her psyche locks. And the music's quite trippy. Pardon me, Iris. I would like to ask you something if you don't mind. I have a distinct feeling you and I have met before.
It must be your imagination, Mr. Edgeworth. After all, I hardly ever leave Hazakura Temple.
Hazakura Temple? What's that?
It's a place where those who wish to boost their spiritual power come to train. You need to undergo some very difficult training to release your inner spiritual power.
Spiritual power? Did you go to that temple for that reason as well?
No, I don't have any spiritual powers. I don't need them.
In that case, what are you doing at the temple then?
I've committed some sins. Sins that I need to pay for. That's why I'm there, and why I continue to train, to purify my soul.
So, I don't know, the entire game's painted Dahlia Hawthorne as the big bad antagonist of the entire game, essentially. So, should I buy this? I don't know if it's an act or not, but should I buy that she's trying to redeem herself here? Or is this actually Dahlia? Man. Oh, and he also handed over all the evidence, I see. Alright. The night of a crime. I want to ask you about last night. The night of a crime.
Alright. I helped to clean up after dinner, and then went back to my room at about 8. Later, I left my room to ring the lights out. Ring the lights out bell at 10.
Bell?
We ring it at the same time each night.
I see. And then?
And then... I was told to go to the training hall, but... I went back to my room and stayed there.
Why didn't you go to the training hall like you were asked to?
I... I was frightened.
Frightened?
So I just stayed in my room and meditated until the murder happened.
There's more to her story. I just know there is. Maybe I should dig a little deeper.
Yeah, what was you frightened about?
You were asked to go to the training hall on the night of a murder.
Yes.
However, you didn't go. So you say you were frightened. What exactly were you so frightened of?
And she's even got some new emotes as well.
Oh man, I just don't trust her.
Alright, she's got two.
But what in the world?
Is there something wrong?
I'm sorry, it's nothing. Looks like she's not aware of them herself. This must be what Wright was talking about. The psycho locks.
Psycho locks. Oh no, she's a psychopath.
I believe it's said that I need to present this Magatama item to do something.
Let me just get the rest of the story first.
So do you have any idea as to what really occurred last night?
I think it was a result of a tremendous spiritual power that was unleashed.
Spiritual power?
Yes, spiritual training has been a cause behind many great tragedies. This incident was just another example.
Iris, I'm sorry, but I can't accept that. I'm a man of science. I don't believe in spiritual power.
Yes, I understand. Most people don't.
And I am certain that the thing that killed the victim was a human. So please, answer me this simple question. Were you the one who killed Elise Dioxnib?
No. I'm not the one who took her life.
Those psycholock things aren't appearing.
And this isn't what it was in the last game, where you had to ask sort of a specific question. Like, In the last game, once it came to... Spoilers if you've not seen it, by the way. Once you came to Martin Guard, you asked him, had you killed Juan Carida? And then he said no. And obviously there weren't any psyche locks there. But the question that you really should have asked is, do you know who killed Juan Carida? And then the psyche locks would have appeared. So the Magatama's... That's its sort of crutch, really, is... If you rely on it too willy-nilly, then you'll not ask the right questions.
I suppose that means I can't believe that she's not lying.
What's wrong?
Can't believe what I'm thinking. And here I just finished saying that I don't believe in spiritual power. It appears that's about all that you can tell me.
Thank you very much for listening to my story.
I visited Wright at the hospital before coming here. He asked me to take care of you.
Did he mean that as some sort of... Does he still care about, or all says, murder the bitch?
Me?
Yes. To a trial tomorrow, he asked me to defend you.
If Mr. Wright has that much faith in you, Mr. Edgeworth, then I'll gladly entrust my fate in your capable hands.
But before that, I have one question.
Yes?
Do you know Wright?
Why would you ask that?
Whenever you came up in our conversation, you would begin to act a little... strange.
Mr. Edgeworth, are you his friend?
Friend? Well, in a sense, yes.
It was 5 years ago. That's when I... deceived him.
You deceived him?
I heard that he was in a lot of pain after what happened. I know what a weak person I am. That's why I thought it was best if he never saw me again. I wanted him to just forget about me, without learning the truth.
Well, if you ask me, Wright is still suffering. And until he learns the truth, I don't think he will ever be able to truly recover. Iris, it's not too late. You should go to him. Tell him the truth. I'll defend you. But only if you agree to that one condition.
All right, Mr. Edgeworth. I promise.
Very well. I'll do everything in my power to get you an acquittal. Oh, Edgeworth's going on the defense stand. Awesome.
so many circles in this trilogy. Because this is it. This was the end of the original trilogy, wasn't it? The first few games. And this is where the story sort of came full circle, I suppose. And to an extent, it, whilst the game's called Phoenix Wright, well, obviously as the titular character, you also got a feel that Edgeworth's pretty much gone through the same, if not more, of a story than Phoenix. I mean, he started off as a bit of an arsehole prosecutor, and now he's taking up defense. That's insane. That's enough information gathering for now. I should head to the crime scene. Right, let me just present the Magatama first and foremost. Oh, the voice lines have changed as well. Since I have been handed this case, it is my duty to dig up all the answers. Understand?
Yes, sir.
The smallest flame can sometimes bathe a case in a whole new light. In my years in court, I've seen it happen over and over again. That's why I'm committed to searching until I have those answers. Now then, is it really true that you didn't go to the Inner Temple last night?
Yes, I swear. I already told you that.
Yes. You said you didn't go because you were frightened.
That's right.
If that's the case, then the obvious question is, what were you so afraid of? Iris, I wonder. Alright. So, photo of Elise. Nah. I don't think it's anything we've got yet. Nope. Hazakura Temple map. No. Iris's hood. No. Okay. We've not got anything else yet. I figured as much. I just wanted to double check before I dove in. Right, but let's also present the... not the Magatama. The Attorney's Badge!
Is that an Attorney's Badge?
Yes, this belongs to Wright.
Really?
I'm actually a prosecutor.
Oh, then why do you have a Defense Attorney's Badge pinned to your lapel?
Well, you see, I borrowed it. Right, okay. Right, well, let's get onto the crime scene, then. Well, shit. We can't get over to our evidences, though. February 8th, Dusky Bridge. Sure is cold, alright? But you wear fluffy scarves, Edgeworth. You should be fine. So this is it. Dusky Bridge. Oh, no.
Mr. Edgeworth.
Oh, no. I thought it would have been, Grossberg.
Mr. Edgeworth. Ah, Detective Gumshoe. Long time no see. It's been about a year. Has it been longer?
It doesn't matter, Detective. What does matter is why you're shuffling around up here.
Oh, ouch. That was a sharp left jab. Well, I'm happy to see you anyway, Mr. Edgeworth.
Let me guess. You were transferred into another section at work. A good choice. The vast amount of nothing up here must be quite easy to guard.
I heard you were back in the country and arranged to come all the way out here. Everybody was real nice. Even let me take charge of the investigation, sir.
Gumshoe indeed. Like gum on your shoe, he's impossible to get rid of.
I'm supposed to report on the details of a crime scene, sir. Anyway, here I am, Detective Dick Gumshoe, reporting for duty.
Great. Thank you, Detective. I thought Prosecutor Godo was going to get here before me.
That guy's a real mystery, I tell ya.
Prosecutor Godo,